us today for the worship service at Calvary Road Baptist Church. Our desire is to equip believers to become fully devoted followers of Christ. Calvary Road has a dynamic ministry committed to worshiping God, loving others, serving others, and inviting others.
Well, good morning, Calvary Road family. How are we doing today? Having a good day? Ooh. How are we doing today? You having a good day, a blessed day?
Yes.
Yes. Amen. Boy, today is a special day in our worship time. We're going to celebrate the Lord's Supper. Communion is always very special for we who are believers. We're going to begin our service this morning by singing two wonderful, very meaningful hymns that's so appropriate for today. Nothing but the blood of Jesus, and then at the cross. So would you stand, all of us together, as we sing together.
There my faith, I receive my sight.
Good morning, and thank you for joining us for Sunday morning worship here at Calvary Road. Visitors, we want to say a special welcome to you. If this is your first time visiting with us, we would ask that you please fill out the Connect card located on the seat in front of you. Also, if you have a prayer need that you would like the staff to be aware of, we would ask that you complete the blue prayer card located in the seat in front of you as well. You can drop your cards in the offering box as you leave the service today. You may also go to our website or mobile app to fill out a Connect card or a prayer request. Here are a few announcements for you to mark on your calendar. If you took a name of a resident at Spicewood Cottages to buy Christmas gifts for, those gifts need to be wrapped and returned by this Wednesday, December the 2nd. Please give these gifts to Joyce early or put them in the room on the right just below the organ. Thank you so much for all of your help. BTW is inviting all to their Jingle Mingle. This is a couples dinner and time of fellowship. It's an opportunity for couples to meet and be involved with a small group, even if you haven't been able to come for a while, or if you are new and interested in our small groups. It will be held Friday night, December 11th at 6:30 p.m. Canini's is catering this event. You can choose from chicken fajitas for $14 or steak for $16. This event will be held in front of the fireplace. Make your check payable to Laura Turner, and you can place it in the tithe box, but do not put it in a tithing envelope, and put BTW Meal on the memo line, or you can drop your check by the church office. The youth will begin a study of the season of Advent, which starts Monday, November the 29th. Advent is a season of hopeful expectations, and we will begin studying the prophecies of Christ and how the Jews were looking and waiting for the coming of the Messiah, and how this shapes our lives as Christians to live in hopeful expectations for His second coming, when He will rule and reign as King forever and ever. We need your help in our children's department. We need additional help in nursery and We Worship. If you would like to help, please go to our website or mobile app to sign up.
Bam! Hey everybody, I'm here to tell you we're going to kick this party up a notch.
Excuse me, Mr. Lasagna, there will be no type of kicking in my kitchen.
Boy, she takes her job way seriously, huh?
Join us Sunday night, December 13th at 6 p.m. Our children will be presenting their Christmas musical, Cooking Up with Christmas. Be sure to come out and support our children.
We're cooking up Christmas, y'all!
Today is the first day that we are collecting our Lottie Moon Christmas offering. Please make your check out to Calvary Road, and on the memo line, please make sure that you mark that it is for Lottie Moon. Our goal for this year is $5,000. Please watch this video with a prayerful heart and pray for what the Lord would have you to give.
Well, good morning, Calvary Road. It's good to see you this morning. Glad we all could be here. Just wanted to emphasize a couple things. One, please, Connie mentioned the thing about writing your checks. Please make sure you make them out to the church. Lottie Moon, she's not alive, so you can't make a check out to a dead person. But please make it out to the church and put in the memo line, put Lottie Moon. There are envelopes on each of the tithe tables that are specifically for the Lottie Moon Christmas offering. If you want to use those, you're more than welcome to. Also on the tables in each of the exits, there are prayer cards, because this week is actually also the week of prayer for international missions. So if that's something that you would like to participate in, you can grab one of those cards on your way out or in, and join in prayer with the International Mission Board. Also, Jeff McCall. Jeff, where are you? Where'd he go? I saw him. Jeff McCall has a Christmas tree, and he wanted me to announce that he would like to invite you to come and grab a name, a child off the Christmas tree at his place of business at Waynesville Tire. So if you'd like to do that, you're welcome to do so. I believe that's everything I had. So let's pray. Father, we thank you for this morning. We thank you so much for the privilege and the opportunity to be here this morning and to be together as believers, as a community. And we thank you for the opportunity and the freedom to do that. God, as we enter into this season of Advent, as we look toward remembering your birth, God, we pray that like the Jews, that we would be in a place of hopeful expectation. That during this time, Lord, we would remember that we too are living our lives in such a way that we are longing and looking for your return. For that time when you will set down on the Mount of Olives once and for all, and you will rule and reign forever. And that we would live our lives that way. And we thank you for today and what it is in the Lord's Supper, that we get a moment to stop and reflect, to examine ourselves, and to remember your sacrifice. And so we pray for our pastor this morning as he brings the message. We pray for the singing. And we pray that everything that we do would be done for your glory and for your gospel, that we would give our lives to take the gospel to the ends of the earth. Lord, we give this time and this service to you. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Now we're going to have our children's message.
Good morning. Oh, did y'all have too much turkey? We did too. Okay, I want to ask all of our boys and girls to stand up. Please stand up, boys and girls. There's a bunch of you out there this morning. Let's give them a hand. Jonas won't stand. Come on, Jonas. Did preacher not give you candy this morning? Did you give him his candy? You did. Okay. Well, this morning, boys and girls, I have a backpack. How many of you carry backpacks? Raise your hand. Yeah, they're kind of important, aren't they? Where do you carry them to? Say it out loud.
School.
Did you hear it? School. Remember how much you missed school just a while back? That's over again, isn't it? Okay, so anyhow, so we take our backpacks to school. Why do we carry a backpack to school? What do you put in your backpack? What, Jonas? What do you say? You go to school and listen to them. That's right. That's right. Or something else. Okay, so that's great, Jonas. But tell me something, guys. Levi, what's something you put in your backpack? An agenda book. Oh, those are important. That tells us what to do every day, doesn't it? It also lets our teachers tell our parents what we didn't do every day. So those can be good or bad. What else do you put in your backpacks? What else? Scarlett? I can't hear her, so someone will have to interpret. Supplies. Supplies. We put supplies in our backpack. Well, you guys think differently than me, so let me show you what's in my backpack. Lunchbox. It's important. We need our lunchbox, right? We need food. How many of you go to school without your lunchbox? Oh, Tanner. Silas. Guys, you're messing up my story. If you don't have your lunchbox, you have money, or you have money on your account for lunch, right? Okay, we got this going on. Okay, we got it going on. So the point of my story is that we have to pack our backpack to go to school every day, and we have to put everything in it that we need. If we forget our agenda book, or if we forget our homework, or if we forget our lunch, our day doesn't go just so, right? I mean, it's hard not to have the things that we need, okay? So this morning, Preacher John is going to lead our church in the Lord's Supper. And we did this not too long ago, and we talked about how that the Lord's Supper is a picture. It's a picture of what Christ did for us when he died for us. His body was broken, and his blood was shed. And boys and girls, he did that so that we could be saved and that he could come and live in our hearts and that the Holy Spirit could guide us and show us how to live. And the way I want to tie your backpack, y'all wondering, to the Lord's Supper is that every day, boys and girls, we need to be reminded of the essential things that we need in our life and our relationship with Jesus and remembering who he is and what he did. That's the most important thing. So make sure that in the mornings when you're packing your backpack or your mom is packing your backpack, that you be reminded of who Jesus is, what he did, and why Christmas is so important. Wow, if he hadn't been born, he couldn't have died for us, could he? It all ties together. Okay. Oh, okay. So at this time, if you have a kid who's going to attend We Worship, you can take them back to the fireplace. I also have one other announcement. Miss Becky Phillips and the decorating crew are going to make our church beautiful tomorrow for Christmas. And so all the Christmas trees are up here at the White Heel House. If you have about 15 minutes after church, if you could drive your car up to the Heel House, we'll load it full of something. We'll bring it down here and carry it in, and that would help them tremendously. Then tomorrow, if you're free around 10 o'clock, they're going to decorate, and they would love to have you come and fluff and trim and do all those beautiful things. Okay? Thank you.
Final word. The cross has the final word. Sorrow may come in the darkest night, but the cross has the final word. The cross has the final. The cross has the final word. Evil may put up his strongest fight, but the cross has the final word. The cross has the final word. The cross has the final word. The Savior has come with the morning light. The cross has the final word. The there's nothing stronger, nothing higher, nothing greater than the name of Jesus. All the honor, all the power, all the glory to the name of Jesus. There's nothing stronger, nothing higher.
Amen and amen. The cross does have the final word. And I want to invite you, would you just stand with us for a minute this morning? And we're going to go to the Lord in prayer together. We thank you for being here. We thank you, those of you that are watching today online. We love you. And we're just thankful today for every blessing of life, every good thing. I hope that through this Thanksgiving, at this time that you've just come through, that thankfulness truly has been at the very top of your list. God's been so good. God has been so gracious. We got up this morning. We got here today. If you woke up this morning and everything's still intact, you have no reason to be down and full of sorrow. We're in the house of God today. And those of you that are home, you're worshiping Him today. And we have the gift of media and internet and all that God's given us so we can stay in contact. But I tell you, all that stuff is so material. It's what God that has given us in the gift of His Son that's the greatest gift. I love in that song that the choir just sang that evil may put on its strongest fight, but the cross has the final word. And in the world we're living in right now, evil is putting up its biggest fight. But in the end of it all, the Lamb of God will have the final say. Aren't you glad you're on His side today? And listen, I know during the holidays there's so much goes on and it's just run, but today we're at a remembrance service. Every Sunday ought to be that. Today is a reminding service, a reminder of the King of Glory who paid for our sins. He traded death for eternal life. So the cross has the final word. He died for you. So as we go further in this time of worship, that's exactly what I hope and pray all of us will do. For those of you at home right now, make sure you get the elements together, whatever that is, crackers, juice. I had somebody tell me all they had was a Ritz cracker and Diet Coke the last time. It's okay. It's all right. It's not what you're eating and drinking. It's who we're remembering that matters. So you gather your stuff together. And before we pray, as you're standing, our ushers have the buckets together that have some extras in it. If you forgot to pick up your little cup when you came through the door, you won't be the only one, so don't be nervous about raising your hand. I forgot and had to go out and get mine right before service. Would you just lift your hand so our ushers can find you, so we'll be prepared right here. Guys in the middle, some others. Lift your hand real high and our ushers will find you if you did not get your cup. Got one up on the front row up here. Appreciate that very much. 2020's changed a lot of things, even the way we do the Lord's Supper. And somebody said this morning that these new ones are like Lunchables. I like that. So you've got the cracker and the juice, and wait till the Christmas Eve service. We've got one that's even easier than these that you'll be able to use. And so here's what I want us to do now. You've come in here, and every time you've been asked, are you all right this morning, it sounded like we were in ICU. So I hope we've moved from ICU. Let's go to a step-down unit now. Let's get our minds together. This is the Lord's Day. I was glad when they said, let's go to the house of the Lord. Make this your sanctuary. Make that your sanctuary at home, wherever you're at. And let's get our eyes on Jesus. Here's what the devil wants us to do. He wants us to forget. He wants you to leave your backpack at home, not remember the essentials that you need to have with you. And if we don't come to church and remember Jesus, we've missed it. We've missed it. When I'm done praying, we're going to go into a time of worship, continuous in song. And this morning we'll have the Lord's Supper together as a family, God's family. Let's pray. Father, it's a joy to be in your house. And if we've lost our focus because of holidays, if we are just down this morning, if our spirits are down, God, if we're just dragging because of all the bad news and all the stuff that's been going on, forgive us, Lord. Forgive us for this time that we have taken our eyes off of you, maybe, and we're all guilty of it. We all have thought about other things. Maybe our minds are moving ahead to the week ahead. But Lord, help us right now, wherever we're at, either home or here in this building, help us to focus on the resurrected Lord, our Savior. Today, Father, we are not in a church building. We're not even at home. We are continually in your presence. That's what we need to see. You are with us wherever we are. And Lord, today in your presence, there is joy. There is peace. We worship you, Lord, today. We remember you. It is our joy to do so. Have your will and way in Jesus' name. Amen.
Situations that tug of war and me all day long, I struggle for the answers that I need. Then I come into his presence, all my questions become clear, and for that sacred moment, no doubts can He was
No. I'm going to have her do the second verse again up to the end. The Bible says when you take the Lord's Supper, you are to examine yourself. Make sure that internally all things are well. Externally, we are here to remember Him, to worship Him. And I don't know about you, but in this old flesh, I have war, don't you? I've had war in this flesh this week. I am not perfect. There's only been one that was perfect, and that is the King of Glory. And I want you to use this second verse today that she's saying. Pay attention to the words, that through His love, the Lord has provided us a place to rest, a place to find the answers in our hours of distress. And there's never any reason to give up in despair. Just slip away and breathe His name, and He'll surely meet you there. As she sings this, let's just talk to our God and be thankful for what He gave us in the gift of His Son, and to make sure that we don't let any junk stay in us from this point forward in this service. Because we're going to hold this bread in a minute and remember His body. And we're going to drink of this cup and remember His blood. And we don't want to go into this in a haphazard, just get through it kind of way. Let's worship Him this morning. And this is just like a time of invitation. A time to invite you to come to the feet of Jesus and just say, Lord, there's sin in my life and I'm sorry. And I want You to clean it out. Or Lord, I'm so distressed, but I've been reminded that You are a place I can run to. So let a man and so let a woman examine themselves.
Through His love, the Lord provided a place for us to rest, a place to find the answers in the hour of distress. No, there's never any reason for you to give up in despair. Just slip away and breathe His name.
Exodus chapter 12, the lamb was sacrificed for the deliverance of the family. And at the cross, the Lamb of God was sacrificed to deliver the whole world from the power and from the penalty of sin. See, the Passover lamb served as the substitute for the firstborn of Israel, but Jesus was our substitute at Calvary. Without the death and without the spreading of his blood, and had they not placed the blood on their homes, the death angel would have truly come in. But because they put the blood on their doorpost, the death angel passed over. It's so true today that without the shedding of blood, we have no hope. Without the shedding of blood, there'd be no remission of sin. Jesus gave his life. Today you hold in your hand this cup, but on the top of it is the bread. It will not become the body. It is a picture of the body. So I want to give you a second. If you are having a hard time peeling that back, ask a neighbor. I know how hard it is to see. It's getting harder for me to see. Just peel the top off and take the bread out. And you hold in your hand something today very sacred. This is a very important moment in the life of any church, is when we are remembering his body. In the book, The Tale of the Tardy Ox Cart, Charles Swindoll tells the story of an 8-year-old Kenyan girl, Monica, who, this little girl fell into a pit and she broke her leg in Kenya. An older woman, seeing what had happened, climbed down into the pit to rescue Monica. But inside that pit, there was a black mamba, the most poisonous snake in Africa. It bit them both. It bit the young girl who had broke her leg, and it bit her rescuer. Both ladies were rushed to a medical center. Monica, the young girl, improved, but tragically, the little older lady who went in to save her died. The young girl could not understand why, what has happened, and the nurse explained it to her. She said, "Listen, here's what happened. The snake bit the older lady first and injected all of its poison. When it bit you, it had no poison left." The nurse went on to explain that Jesus had done the very same thing. He had taken the poison of our sin so that we could live. Monica understood that story when she heard it that way and immediately received Christ as her Savior. A powerful illustration today to remind you that Jesus took it all. There's nothing more we can do to earn our salvation. Jesus paid it all, and all to him we owe. Stripes were laid into his body. His beard was plucked. He was slapped. He was spit on. He was nailed to a tree. And he gave every drop of blood that he had for each one of us and for the sins of the whole world. The deadly poison of sin came to destroy and to kill us. But Jesus took all that poison and he gave us his life. His life for ours. That's why the cross has the final word. There's no way to heaven except through the blood of Jesus. God did not give his son so that we could conjure up another way to get into heaven. They're not multiple roads, folks. All religions do not end in the same destination. We cannot coexist with multiple religions. The Bible is dogmatic about the fact that Jesus is the only way. He is our only hope. It is through Jesus that we have been redeemed and set free. This is His body, a symbol of His body. And a reminder to you today, He gave His body, He gave His life for you and for me. Father, we thank You this morning for the gift of Your body. You left the splendor of heaven, wrapped Yourself in a man's suit, came to this earth. You went through every experience that we go through. You suffered like no other. And today we honor that. We come reverentially to You today. We approach Your throne in the holiness this morning of what that entails. And we are reminded that You gave everything You had for us. And Lord, remind us today, even though it is hard to look at, remind us today of the stripes that were laid on Your back. Remind us today of the nails that pierced Your hands and feet. Remind us today that greater love had no man than this, than a man that would lay down his life for his friends. Today You are our only hope. You are the only way. And today we thank You for the gift You gave of Your life for each one of us. Amen. Jesus took the bread and He broke it, and after He blessed it, He gave it to them and said, "Take, eat, this is My body which is broken for you. As oft as you do this, you do it in remembrance of Me."
death could not hold you. The veil tore before you. You silenced the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory, for you are raised to life again. You have no rival, you have no equal, now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is, what a powerful
Amen. What a name. You see, this is personal. When they stood in the room together with Jesus and they were taken of this Passover, that would be the last one like they had ever known. They had always celebrated Passover, but this one had turned. It had changed. Something was different. Jesus was saying things in a different way. It wasn't remembering a lamb and the blood on a doorpost. He was saying, I'm giving you my body. It's broken for you. This is personal. Maybe you're like us. I know you are. We all receive a lot of junk mail, don't we? And junk mail, when you look at it, I can't get over how many times they don't even get my name right. I'm a swinger, swamper. Swagger, swaggert. Very seldom do they even get everything right. It's just an impersonal, slapped-on thing that's just mass-mailed out. But every now and then, you go to the mailbox, and there's something in there that's handwritten. And sometimes it doesn't get any more precious to me than I can go to the mailbox or come into my office, and there's a letter on my desk, and I can tell that the hand that wrote it probably shook a good bit. And they've spelled out my name personally. They have put pen to the paper and hand wrote me a letter. It's personal. With junk mail, I don't know how you do, but at our house it goes in a fire. Just burn it up, get rid of it. Maybe you have a shredder. But those personal letters. See, Jesus wanted us to know that what I'm doing, he told his disciples, I'm doing for you. And you can put your name there. I'm doing this for you, John. I'm going to the cross, and I am going to take this brutal punishment for you. And for every sin that you ever commit, I'm going to take your punishment for you. Boy, that's personal. For you. But then he asked us to make it personal. He said, so when you do this in remembrance of me. We're not here today to remember an organized religion. We're not doing this because it's a Baptist thing to do. It is a commandment, an ordinance that God left the church. And we're doing this today because we want to remember him. I don't know of a better way to kick off your Christmas season than to make sure that at the forefront of your mind is the whole reason there is a season is because God so loved the world, he gave his only son. And his son would give every drop of blood he had so that you and I could have life, eternal life. Take a moment and peel back the top of your juice. I know it's a little sticky. Jesus said, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood." Things are going to change, he was saying. We won't remember a lamb whose blood was shed and placed over a doorpost, but from now on, you'll remember the Lamb God gave. You'll remember me, and I give you my blood. I give it and I shed it for you. Father, we thank you today for the shed blood. We thank you for thinking enough of us to give us everything you had. Today we are united in here as a family. Those who are watching online, saved by your precious blood, we are brothers and sisters in Christ. We have been united by your blood. Sure, we may pull for different teams and live in different houses, and we may eat different foods. We may even have different ideas on things. But when we came to you and we asked you to save us, then we were made together. We were united in this thing, and that is you. Because of the blood, we have life. And one day, Lord, we will all stand together in your presence. We will all be there together. And it'll all be made possible because of the shed blood that you gave to each and every one of us. And today we thank you. We thank you for the gift of our salvation. We thank you for the blood that you shed. Precious is the flow that makes us whiter than snow. Amen. Jesus took the cup and said, "This is the New Testament in my blood, and as oft as you drink it, you do it in remembrance of me."
Crimson love,
Amen. Amen. Let's stand together today. I've never in my ministry tried to add anything to this service. There is no greater message could be preached than the message you just held. The bread and the cup. And remember, that was for you. And I just want to say to you today, God has never sent anybody to hell. They go there because they reject the blood. And I pray that you won't do that. If you're in this building today and you've never truly accepted what God's done for you, listen, being in church today won't get the job done. Why, you could have even took the bread and the cup, but it's not going to do anything. Have you taken Him? Have you trusted Him? And so I just pray today that this message of the bread and the cup will stay with us all. Because right now the enemy's doing everything he can to deter our minds away from who Jesus is. He wants us to be distressed. He wants us to be down. He wants us to get our eyes off of the joy of knowing Jesus. If he can get us in a political shouting match, if the devil can get us at one another's throats over a virus, he wins. But I'll tell you what can unite us. What can keep us together? Jesus and what he's done for us. Listen, we can have differences of opinion on ball and food. You may even decorate your house different than I would. That don't matter. What unites us is the love of Jesus. So I say to us as a church family coming into this season of Thanksgiving and Christmas, let's stay together. Let's stay together and rally around King Jesus. He's worth it. Don't give up. Don't give up. Let's just keep plowing. I think it's coming where this will all settle down and we won't worry about getting each other sick. We'll have another problem to deal with. Corona will be in the rearview mirror. But I heard this week, and when I say corona, I meant the virus. I heard a great saying this week reminded me of something. I want to leave you with it today. There's a reason the rearview mirror is way smaller than the windshield. You got to look forward, not back. It's all right every now and then to peep in the rearview mirror. You can see what God brought you out of. But don't stay there. Keep looking ahead. Amen. I love yous. Yep, you're going to beat a lot of people to the drive-in throughs today. But listen, we still need a little help. If you can hang around and help get some decorations down here to the church, we'd greatly appreciate it. We love you. Have a blessed Sunday. And can't wait to see you again.
Well, thanks for being with us in worship today. It is our heart's desire that through the Word and through this worship service today, God has spoken to your heart and you desire to serve Him and to worship Him more than you ever have in your life. You know, if you've been watching today and you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ, that is our greatest desire. If we can be a help to you, if we can assist you in any way, please contact us at the information you see on the screen. We also want to thank those of you who watch us regularly. We greatly appreciate your prayer and support. keep praying for us as we pray for you, as we serve the Lord together.
Strength.